Within the cortex of this immature ovary, we find some primordial follicles. Primordial follicles are visible or recognizable because you can see flattened follicular cells surrounding a large oocyte. These follicles are found within the cortex of the ovary. Now the pointer is on the oocyte. Here we see a primary follicle. The pointer is actually on the oocyte, but the oocyte is surrounded by a single layer of cuboidal cells. Note the difference. The cells surrounding the oocyte are no longer flattened squamous cells. Here is a primary follicle with multiple layers of cuboidal cells surrounding the oocyte. Even though the oocyte isn't visible inside, at least the nucleus of it, you can still get a sense that there is an oocyte surrounded by multiple layers of cuboidal cells. Now we're looking at a secondary follicle. Secondary follicle is recognizable because it has an antrum filled with Lacquer folliculi, and the pointer is indicating the antrum. The Lacquer folliculi is found within it. Here's a larger secondary follicle, the larger, more developed antrum. Now we are indicating the oocyte in the secondary follicle. Here the pointer is on follicular cells forming this follicle. The corona radiata is seen here, and the cumulus ophorus is indicated by the pointer. In this slide, the pointer is indicating a secondary follicle. The secondary follicle grows and matures and becomes a Graafian follicle. And you can see a Graafian follicle at the top of this slide. Also toward the bottom are secondary follicles that are heading toward becoming Graafian follicles. Here is another large Graafian follicle in the center of this field, and over onto the left, about 9 o'clock, you can see a secondary follicle. That's the difference between a secondary and a mature Graafian follicle. Difference in size. Here we see the corpus luteum. What used to be the Graafian follicle has now filled in with cells and has become its own little mini gland, the corpus luteum.